All right, Jingo here with another video. Today we're going to be having a look at the new mashup pack, the Fallout mashup pack. I gotta say, as a big fan of Fallout, I really like this pack. They did a great job on it, even the creative world that they got going. You can see they spent a lot of time trying to recreate some of the old scenery from Fallouts of the days gone by, as well as a lot of stuff that people will recognize from Fallout 4. All in all, it was a good job. There's a creeper there. Zombie pigman. Another zombie. That's a skeleton. Looks like a ghoul. So we're just going to have a little look-see at the textures, give you guys a brief little tour. Just for anybody who's thinking of whether or not to spend the $7 or $8 it costs to get this thing. Like I said, if you're a Fallout fan like I am, from way back in the day when Interplay had it like 20 years ago, you'll really love this. So we've got Red Rocket Gas Station, which I'm sure you'll all recognize if you've played Fallout 4, and of course... can't have your own Fallout game without building your own vault. So I started my own little vault here underneath the gas station. So, lots of neat little textures. Everything else. Portal. Even the Nether itself, they did a fantastic job. We can take a little spin through that later. So, anyway, just getting started on that. So let's have a look at the board itself. Like I was saying earlier, they did a fantastic job recreating a lot of the scenery that anyone who's played Fallout of the past will recognize. Everything from the Diamond City. Oh yeah, this is the only thing I'm not terribly impressed with. I mean, they redid the spiders, but they should have made them into rad scorpions. But that, what I would have to say, is my only complaint. So here, anyone should recognize, this is Sanctuary Hills from Fallout 4 as well. So, tons of little villages scattered here and there. They even redid the vault itself. We'll have a little look-see in here. It's a shame they couldn't make that elevator work. So, bats were turned into bloatflies. All in all, nice textures. Bolts, large areas. Just seems to go on and on sometimes. There you get the gist of it. We'll look at some of the more prettier recreations they've done. Did a fabulous job recreating the ruins of Washington, D.C.
Into each life some rain must fall. But too much
is one of the airships you might recognize. Over here we've got the Diamond City.
Must fall, but someday the sun will shine. Some folks can lose
over here, the ruins
the
of DC.
In their heart.
I mean, mean, look at that.
But when I think of you, another shower starts.
And of course, you can
into each line,
go inside, climb your way all the way up to the top here.
Must fall, but too
and then,
much is
jump out.
In mine.
Lots of cool stuff lying around. These are the
into each life, some rain.
Elytra wings. Light it, glide and fly and
but
do whatever else.
Too much is falling in mine.
Into lots of little villages.
But someday the sun will shine.
Oh, the vault dwellers and little settlers.
Some folks can lose the blues in their hearts. But when I think of you, another shower starts. Into
yes, the fabulous job capturing that rust color we all love.
But too much is falling in my.
Oh, and of course, don't can't forget everybody's favorite Brahmin. Let's have a look.
Some rain has got to fall.
Two-headed Brahmin.
But too much of that stuff has fallen into mine. And into each heart, some tears has got to fall. I know that someday that sun is bound to shine.
The infamous Tenpenny Tower.
Some folks can lose the blues.
I'll remember from Fallout 3.
But when I think of you, another shower starts. Into each life,
the big cathedral.
Some rain must fall, but too much is falling.
Again, like I said, they put a lot of work into this. It's all very impressive. Even including various vaults. Vault 8, 101. And then to top it all off, they linked everything up with an actual working subway system. So they've got all kinds of mine carts around. Here, we'll have a little look-see. Go down to the subway. Expanding on all this, but it keeps going. Map. You can see lots of stuff to look at. Like I said, all in all, very well done. So anyone who's considering buying this, your Fallout fan, it's a must-have. And hope everybody enjoys this little showcase and hope you found it useful in making your decision. Other than that, this is Jingo signing off. Have a good day.